What's up, Ray? How's it going, bro?
Glad you live around here now.
What's going on, man? Brother. What are you up to today, man?
Just coming from the bank.
Okay.
Yeah, I gotta pay my lawyer for all these false allegations. Cost money.
Okay. So you're at the bank getting that for your lawyer right now?
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Too much money. That's all I gotta say.
So, I'm under the impression you're about to start fighting back against all this stuff and. Like you were telling me last time that the charges aren't true and all that.
Yeah.
So like.
Well, here's what happened. I did a whole entire YouTube that I was gonna drop, but I can share that with you.
Okay, you have it. So what? Yeah. So are you gonna be explaining yourself and your side of the story, or?
So I basically wanna I just wanna explain to people because they don't understand the process.
Okay.
Of what just happened, but my case was completely dropped both by the county and the city.
Okay.
And there's a new city attorney who picked it up. But what is extremely perplexing is that a city attorney will pick up this case not realizing, at the expense of the taxpayers and not knowing that there was a restraining order put against this girl.
Okay.
So I don't think she knows because the evidence is that she hit me.
Okay.
And so why would you even pick up a case and try to charge me for domestic violence when she clearly admits that she hit me?
Did she hit you?
Exactly.
Okay, so what, you have like a video that you like put together explaining everything in detail?
Yeah, I can send you that if you give me your email and stuff.
Yeah, do that, definitely. Yeah, because I mean, people want to know because I mean, everybody knows you from like Team 10 and doing pranks and, like vlogs and stuff like that. And, you know, once something like that is out on the internet,
it lives perpetually online. That means if people don't know the word perpetually means it lives forever on social media.
Right.
Whether you're guilty in the courts or not guilty, it's going to look like I'm guilty online always.
Okay.
So these videos are actually good for me, so thank you.
Okay, no doubt. Well, do you have a message to your fans, like they've been down with you since day one?
Of course. Yo, guys, I never hit a woman in my entire life, okay? So let that be known. And thank you so much for being here for me.
So what else is going on with you, man?
Other than I'm not guilty.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Oh, shoot, my fit plan launched today, bro.
Okay, what's going on with that?
Baby. So I was going to launch it in the summer.
Okay.
But because of all the fake allegations, I now launched it today.
Okay.
So I'm super excited. So anybody who wants to try my 30-day program right now, baby, go to my Instagram right now. Click the link, baby, and you're going to be in the best shape in your life.
Okay, all right.
So that's what I got going on.
Okay.
Thank
sounds good.
Thank you for making
good.
Me smile.
No doubt, man. No doubt. All right, cool. I'll see you later, man.
So, I wanted to highlight some key facts to set this distorted record straight once and for all. I was about to file a civil claim for $2 million in lost wages, and this frivolous suit is only going to compound to this. What's extremely perplexing to me is that a city attorney will pick up this case at the expense of the taxpayers when the recordings were used in discovery. For the record, it completely exonerates me and validates that the new prosecutor for the city is just looking for a way to build her name on the taxpayer's expense. I would also like to add that I did care for Mrs. Hicks, and I never, ever dreamt that she would take it to these extremes just because the relationship did not work. So in today's day and age, the figure of speech that we will clear his name only makes sense for the court. Okay, that means in the court's eye, I am not guilty. Because of Mrs. Hicks' false allegations against me, it will live perpetually on social media forever. And there's a lot of people who can relate to this. I want to read this. Miss Hicks admitted to the LA Superior Judge that she hit me multiple times. We're going to have transcripts of this, of the hearing that day where the judge granted me a domestic violence restraining order and a revenge porn restraining order against Miss Hicks. Those transcripts will be available to any news outlet. The final restraining orders will articulate the findings and illuminate any ambiguity against me. Miss Hicks clearly vindicates that I never hit her. She admittedly said that to the judge. And she also said it to my sister on an audio. Miss Hicks is violating her restraining order. A notice from my lawyer to remove anything off of social media. On her social media and anything involving these allegations, she is ordered by the court to remove it. Anything on Keemstar, all these other accounts that have her recording her voice needs to be taken down or she is held in contempt. This is not a joke, guys. This girl's life could change dramatically and I do not want that. So if you have any recordings on her, please take it down. It can affect her life dramatically, could be held in contempt, and she will go to jail. This is not taken lightly. The judge will be offended. that she did not go out there and clean her mess up and do exactly what she was ordered to do by the court. Now I have audio recordings that clearly establish a pattern of conduct, meaning that what she consistently does and beating up her boyfriends, and she's bragging about it, and she has an audio and that she's clearly explaining to my sister saying how she's done this before. Tits clearly vindicates me on how I never hit her. She says it in her own words. And I have audio and proof of that as well. Miss Hicks also has violated her restraining order that she needs to take down any video or audio related to the incident. And she still needs to take anything off her social media. My lawyer sent her a notice to remind her to take anything off her social media and anything related to the case she must take down as well. It's not just on her actual page. I do not want her to be held in contempt. Things get serious real quick when the judge feels that someone did not listen to them. Now, I have recordings that clearly establish a pattern of conduct where Mrs. Hicks elaborates on how she beats up her boyfriends. I also have proof that Mrs. Hicks premeditated all of this. There is an actual person who came to me who talks about how they seen the footage before it came up, how she explained to them what she was going to do with the actual footage that she put on Keemstar when she illegally recorded me, which needs to be taken down by her because the court said anything involving the case or any social media posts involving her before or after is supposed to be removed. Now, I want to come here and end it with this. With all the overwhelming proof that vindicates me, we have proof through her keyword searches back in May 2018 before the alleged incident that Mrs. Hicks was researching when you accuse someone of doing something without proof of law. So she was looking into figuring out how to accuse me of something without proof, which is clear validation of her premeditative motive. In addition, like I said before, we have her Google research as well. So with all the research and discovery we have, there's a pattern of conduct here, guys. Pattern of conduct means is what she consistently does. She openly and admittedly talks about this, explaining how she beat up her boyfriend. She talks about how she hit me. This is a pattern of conduct. This is something she does on a regular. And this is in her own words, not somebody saying she did this. This is her admitted in her own words. She vindicates, literally clears my name by saying, he never hit me. You can't accuse somebody of hitting you and then in her own voice stating to my sister that she has never been hit by me. And another key point here is the premeditated thing. Premeditated means that you actually think about this in advance. She was doing Google researches. She was talking about it with friends. I have actual people coming to me explaining what her process was. And this is all premeditated. This is all illegal. Do you guys know that in California, there's so many people dying? So many people dying. Do you know in Chicago, there's so many people dying? There's some real cases going on in these cities that people are violent and really dangerous. And the city attorney wants to waste the taxpayers' money on my case that was already dropped by the county and the city already once. Why would you waste your time picking up this case? There's real crimes going on right now, today. You need to go handle that. Oh.